Good day, everyone. Welcome again to another edition of Fayette Focus. Harry Wright with you. Today, my guest from the Fayette, we've got MRDD. Is that, no, it's not MRDD. It's just DD, isn't it?
Correct. Fayette County Board of DD.
Fayette County Board of DD. Tim Stewart, how are you?
Good, Harry. How are you?
All right. And you brought along?
Lori Moore, also from
Fayette. Lori, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
All right. Now, we got spaghetti dinner coming up. Let's talk about it.
Yes, sir. March 24th, we have our annual Dwight Turner spaghetti dinner.
Tell us a little bit about the dinner and what the proceeds go for.
The dinner annually we always do. You get spaghetti, breadsticks, a salad, and a dessert, all for $5 if you pre-order your tickets, $6 at the door. And all proceeds benefit our local Special Olympics program.
Now, Lori, tell us a little bit about the Special Olympics program here in Fayette County and what the money is used for in that project.
Okay. The Special Olympics program, they provide track and field, softball, basketball, and then the money goes towards uniforms and just stuff that they need to provide the service of the Special Olympics.
You know, people hear Special Olympics, that word Olympics is attached with it. You know, this is an Olympic year. We're watching them on TV. But, you know, they say, well, they don't need money. They're the Olympics. Olympics has money. But that's not the way that it is in Fayette County with the Special Olympics, is it?
No, not for us. The only money we get is actually from these fundraisers that come in. We get nothing from the state. It's all local proceeds that we get through these fundraisers, like our annual basketball game and spaghetti dinner.
And the money goes to buy like uniforms and shoes and travel expenses, because moms and dads have to foot all this expense.
That's correct. Yep.
So now we've got a basketball game coming up too, another fundraiser coming up. It's become a fantastic annual event. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, this year it's a little different. We're having it on March 21st. We'll feature both of our teams, our JV Special Olympics team and our varsity Special Olympics team. The JV will play a new team, Team Hazmat, which consists of some hazmat people from the fire department this year, and then our varsity team will tip off against the Guns and Hoses at roughly 7:30 p.m. that night.
It all depends on how long the first game goes.
That's correct.
That's right. That game is so much fun, and it's well attended, and it's like a buck to get in or something like that. Or what are we charging to get in this year?
$3 at the door.
There you go. $3. Yeah, it's no big deal. But a lot of people come. It's a wonderful game, and a lot of people have fun.
It is. We usually pack the gym, and also we have the special halftime show again this year, same one we had last year. He did an excellent job, and he will be back.
It was kind of funny because last year they played the Guns N' Hoses, and he started out with a little bit of a slash from Guns N' Roses.
Correct, yes. It was a great time.
Now tell us a little bit about the entertainment, because he was phenomenal. But he's got, is it Asperger's or?
Autism.
Autism, yes. Okay.
And he is self-taught. He has taught all the music and all his guitars playing by himself.
You know, when they said that last year, and you're thinking, okay, you know, how good's the guy going to be? And then he comes out with that rip from, you know, Guns N' Roses. And then not only that, but everything else that he played, it's like phenomenal.
Yeah, he's great. Like she said, he's was diagnosed with autism at 4 and has been self-taught guitarist since the age of 12, I believe. And he actually has perfect pitch. He can hear a song and replay it perfectly.
And I'll tell you, folks, that right in itself right there is worth the $3. Not to mention, though, the great sportsmanship in basketball. I know we're going to be broadcasting it on the radio again, but folks, you've got to come and see this game and be a part of it. It is the 21st of March. It's at the Washington Senior High School, correct?
That's correct.
All right, so come on out, Washington Senior High School, the 21st of March, and get the game. And with the spaghetti supper is?
March 24th from 4 to 7 p.m.
Oh, so you can make a whole week of it. You can go Wednesday to the game and then come right around and go to get some spaghetti.
Yes, sir.
All right, now if people want to buy some tickets ahead of time, how do they get a hold of them?
They can purchase any tickets at Fayette Progressive Schools in town or at the Fayette County Board of DD.
There you go, folks. So, hey, make sure two events. Spaghetti dinner the 24th of March. 21st of March is the big basketball game between the Dragons and the Guns and Hoses. And now you'll have concessions and everything there, won't you?
Correct. Yes. There's be concession stand. There'll be T-shirts, everything.
I was going to ask about those really cool I'm a Fan T-shirts.
Yes. As far as I know, they will be there.
All right. So anything else you got for the people before we take off for the day?
Yep, we just like to see a large crowd out, and then hopefully we get the support from the community.
All right, folks, come on out. March 21st, it's $3. It's the best basketball game that you will see all year. It's the Guns and Hoses and the Fayette County Dragons. And then that Saturday, come on out and get some spaghetti and all the trimmings and help out our Special Olympics in Fayette County. I want to thank Tim and Lori for coming on the program today and being a part of our show. Thank you guys very much.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir.